Right, welcome back to Flightson 2020 and welcome back to the High Performance Group H145. And yes, despite what it looks like in front of us, we are actually in South Africa. So a couple of weeks ago, we had this massive kind of snowstorm and everything in the highlands near the Drakensberg and Lesotho, where we are now, was covered in snow for a couple of days. And of course, that led to a lot of issues and emergency crews had to respond. So that's what we're doing today. We are parked here at Dragon's Peak Heliport, which is kind of on the eastern side of the Lesotho border and the Drakensberg Mountains. And we've been stationed here in preparation to assist with the snowstorm. And it looks like this early Saturday morning, we have a road accident in Lesotho that we're going to be assisting with. So that is the plan for today's flight. And as you can see, it's mostly raining, but the temperatures are still pretty low. So there's still a bit of snow falling, but everything is covered in snow and clouds and poor visibility all over. So this is going to make things kind of interesting, but we're pretty much ready to go. We're going to pop our engines into flight mode. Our very first mission is loaded up. We're fully fueled up because the weather's not great. What I do need is this over here, and that needs to come on. This needs to be on. And we'll turn the landing lights on now as well, which is going to be pretty bright against the snow. So I think we're going to head out in that direction and gain some altitude and then kind of swing around, because the peak or the mountain is just off to our left here. So I think that's going to be the easiest. Let's get up in the air. See what we can do. Feels good. This weather's really going to make things interesting. At least it seems to be a little bit clearer out towards the sunrise. But of course, that's the opposite to where we're actually going. So I think we're just going to keep gaining altitude here. We're going to have to rely on that synthetic vision quite a bit to get through the mountains. Now, the accident appears to be just on one of the main highways through the area, so no particular place. At least we have the highway to land on. I think that's going to be our best bet. This looks really nasty going in here. Sort of stick to this valley. Ish, that goes up this way. We head into the clouds again. You can see the sun hitting the highest peaks up there. So once we get through this layer of cloud, we might actually be fine. Is 1 degree, so we might, unfortunately, with the flightsim weather, if that temperature increases to the point where the snow kind of starts melting. It all kind of disappears in like a couple of seconds. I think it's only going to get colder as we head higher up here. Right, at least we can see now what's going on. So we're looking at about a 20 minute flight as is. Now we're not going particularly fast at the moment because we're still basically going vertical to get over the mountains here. Let's push in a little bit more active so we can nose over a bit and pick up some speed. But look at that. Yeah, it appears we're out of the weather. It's kind of sitting in that valley down there. Almost perfect. Okay, we're picking up speed. We're now down to about 15 minutes flight time. And we kind of just need to make it over that ridge in front of us. And then we can really pick up the pace. Although we're probably not going to go too much faster. Just over 100 knots now. Sure why this isn't working. It normally does. Something that I don't have switched on. Look at where I'm going. So that's all on. That's on. Everything is on. Something down here. So this is just the audio. Sure. Yeah, as we come over the top here, to be honest, we can actually probably turn these landing lights off. Looks like as we descend on the other side, if we are going to descend, I think that's a bit of a lower area where the road is. It looks like we're going to be heading into the clouds again, which might make landing on the road a bit of a challenge. Just under 10 minutes out. Clouds there to make our landing, which is okay. We should be fine if it's the same as the weather was when we took off. It'll be okay. Feet. And 5 minutes out. Coming up to that weather, so now we need to start looking for the highway, which we should be able to see kind of soon. I think that's the closest point somewhere in there, but I reckon it's going to be down in this valley here. There's a valley coming up just in front of us there. It's probably going to be somewhere down in there. Maybe not. Must be the next one, but then it's covered in cloud completely. Yeah, it's not this one. This one's the river that's coming up over here. So it looks like we've got a big ridge to get over, and then it's on the other side. That puts it firmly in the clouds. looks like we go over this ridge and we should be able to pick up the road. I'm wondering if we should kind of stick to the right here. Maybe try and stay out of the clouds, pick up the highway, and then we can descend where we can see and follow the highway into the accident site. Over this next ridge, that's the second one. That's where we should pick up the road. Okay, plenty of fuel on board. Minus 3 now outside, we're 2 miles away. It's down in this valley here. I'll start backing off the power just a bit, so we're gonna have to descend in here. There's the highway, I can just make out in front of us. So I think we're gonna drop in here and dip down in this area where we can see at least. Still cars moving on the road, which is not expected. Oh, look at this steep section here. Looks like the visibility gets really bad just up there. I think we're gonna have to go just into that. It's pretty steep here as well to land. We might have to land perpendicular to the road. Emergency vehicles or anything. Back into the rain. Now that we've gone past it, or that's it up ahead. We're still coming up to it, so I think that might be it up ahead there, just other side of the building. Visibility's okay. other side. There's a telephone line literally above the accident site. Lightning, which came at a very awkward time because I was just thinking if we try and hoist and we put the cable into the power line, that could go quite badly. I'm not sure going to be able to touch down on this slope here. It's kind of not great. So I think what we'll do, the tree is kind of close in front of us. We inch forward, there's a kind of flattish spot over here. But I want to face the other direction. It's nice and smoothly. Great time for the sim to stutter, of course. Okay, this will work. Stable, so we'll go engines 1 and 2 idle. And they can jump out. I just want to check if this is actually set correct. So that's standby, that's normal, and that's mute, so it should be in the middle. So that is right. Starting to sound a bit more intense. Look at the rain coming in from that side. So let's see if we can get out of here. That rolls in. I think we'll head down the road a little bit in that direction. Cut into one of these valleys out that way, something like that. what is causing this to be on. Anyway, not the end of the world, because we have the synthetic vision at least. 2 degrees outside now. That rain, I think, is going to be heading this way. Bit of an incline, which is not ideal. I have to pick a hospital. None of these are hospitals, these are just helipads. Might even have to head there. There's another one there. What's that? Ladysmith. That's probably the best. All the way to Pietermaritzburg. What's up here? Probably one of these is... Clarence is like here somewhere. That's probably got a hospital. I think we're probably going to be doing Ladysmith. Possibly even Pietermaritzburg, which is going to be quite a long flight. Got the fuel at least. It sounds like they're loading him in at the back there. He's back in.
Cabin is secure.
What is this one? Maybe that one. Is this a hospital? Alright, that is just a... think. Yes, because we can't accept that. Do Ladysmith. Let's do that one. Yes, it seems. I just wanted to see if I could change. Grays and medic. Yeah, so we're heading back to what? Well, we're heading to Ladysmith now. Is that updated? Yes, it has. Right, let's go flights and flights. This seems okay. It actually might be moving away from us. Wait for the rotor RPM to stabilize. Okay, RPM stable. To head that way, but we're going to gain some altitude first. Lightning's getting worse and worse up there. Staying away from that at least. That could have made things a lot worse. close this for now. Let's go in here and just make sure we don't fly into the side of the mountain by doing this. Actually, I want to change this back. Just under 9,000 feet, so we gotta climb up to about 10 and a half again to get through here. Weather ahead of us, but we're gonna swing in that direction shortly, so we should be okay. Plenty of fuel on board, 28 minutes to the hospital. Up to about 10,500 feet. Looks like I'm gonna need to pass through some rain. Let's go to the side. In between these two little cells here, and then swing right on the other side. Temperature now -4. And by the way, I'm using Active Skies historic weather to get the weather from the snowstorm. So just set it to that Saturday date. So this is the live weather from that day. So that's how I'm doing the weather for the snowstorm. Okay, this is kind of the highest point we're going to deal with. So we can level off here. And it looks like we might end up having to go through some of this weather at some point. I don't know if we can get around this completely. That's going to take us forever to go all the way around that way, so might just have to go through it eventually. Heading straight into the wind now as well, although it's not crazy. Feet now. Out 130-ish knots. Helipads here. This is the Cathedral Peaks Hotel. Let's see if we can spot that. I think we're going to turn just before it though. Stay to the right of that patch of weather there. Oh, there's the weather updating again. Too bad, but looks like we're gonna have a bit of rain and cloud. Cathedral Peaks Hotel somewhere in there. Keeping the gradual descent, so it will be descending pretty much all the way there. Already coming through, well, coming up to 9,000 feet now. spot that we started off from is just out that way. Yeah, it feels good. 2.5 hours roughly remaining, 14 minutes to go to the hospital. Coming up to our max speed now because we're descending as well. Okay, 6:35 and we're expecting to be there at 6:48. As we descend, temperature is going to rise. We might actually find the snow disappearing. Okay, it's about 148 knots now. Feet. Temperature has just gone over zero. We now had one. Start leveling out, or at least reducing that descent rate to a couple of feet a minute. Let me see, Bergville. Yes, there's the town of Bergville over there. Still says 10 minutes to go because we've slowed down. slight climb on. There we go. That's about level. Probably sitting around 130 knots. 128-ish at the moment. Ladysmith's just coming to view on the map now. Down slightly. There we go. Start descending. How far are we? 50 miles, about 6 minutes. Ladysmith yet. So with all this moisture in the air, the sun is quite intense. It's 6:44 in the morning. ETA 6:49. 5 minutes out, 12 miles. Feel 2 hours, 19 minutes, plenty on board. Let's get our landing light on. Thirty knots, that's good speed. outside temperature is at 3. Oh, no, it's still 1. So as always, there isn't going to be an actual physical helipad at the hospital. We'll just need to find a place on the ground that we can land. Now, because everything's covered in snow, normally you can just see the texture on the actual satellite image. But now, because of the snow, I don't think that's going to work. So this actually might be a little bit more interesting. That's the view I wanted, so let's maybe zoom this way in so it'll help us when we get closer. It's out 5.8 miles. Left all that stormy weather behind us. Back there in the mountains. Here's the highway into Ladysmith. Start slowing down. Any buildings yet. We can just stop by the airport after dropping the patient off at the hospital, and we'll stay there on standby. Find the parking. Kind of in the middle here somewhere. So over the river, and just before the road. this big building over here. And where can we set it down? It's before the other big road, not this little road. That road there. So it's this big building. There's a nice open patch behind it, which on the map just appears to be like a field over there. That looks kind of clear. Let's see if we can do that. Wind is coming straight behind us. I can see there's the little marker for the helipad. So this is exactly where it is. The marker that's placed there by the mission system. That's all I'm seeing, which we're landing basically right on top of it, which means the helipad might be a little bit behind us actually. They place that at the front of the helipad. This should be okay. There's the marker right there. Thank you. go back to flight. We're just gonna pop over here to the Ladysmith Airport. Get up there to remain on standby. They've actually given us another rescue, but we're not doing another one for today. We're just gonna head to the airport. Okay, let's just wait for the rotor RPM to be stable. Waiting for that light to extinguish. There we go. Alright, let's get out of here. Okay, out into the wind. From that side, although we're gonna have to just land onto the apron, which faces kind of to our right. So at least if we do this, we can approach into the wind. At the end there. That's okay. If I park too close to the fuel thing, it's probably actually going to open it up for refueling. Just want to make sure that we're on the actual apron here. Spawned in a very bad place. Yeah, landing lights off. Let's do pizza heat. These guys can come off. Actually, this should have done idle first to give it a bit of a chance to spool down. lights all off, and then lastly we can turn this off. Okay, and there we are at Ladysmith Airport after successfully rescuing that person from the car accident in the snow. Look, the clouds and the weather seems to be building up again. So it looks like we made it back in just in time. And we might do some other missions later on in the afternoon. I'm sure there will be more need for the EMS H145. Once again, this is the High Performance Group H145. We've just been using the action pack to go ahead and do some rescue missions. But that's going to bring us to the end of the video. As always, if you made it all the way to this point, thank you so much. I really do appreciate you watching. And if you did enjoy it, you know what to do down below. And I'll see you in the next one.